Welcome to Coaches Weekly. I'm CJ Sellner, here with head men's soccer coach Michael Arango. Coach, a 1-1 week that really was highlighted with that Rockford match. Just what are some of your takeaways?
The Rockford match was an extremely tough match going into, and we did a great job of putting together our game plan and scoring early and often, and that really put Rockford on their heels. Coming late in the second half, we dodged a PK and got the game winner late in that match as well.
I thought in that match, it really shows that you guys have a really kind of diverse offense that has a lot of people that have the ability to kind of put the ball in the back of the net.
Yeah, we're trying to give these guys a little bit of freedom to express themselves and play the way they want up there, while at the same time teaching them that if you're going to do that, you also can't give the ball away, because that opens up to a lot of counterattacks. And so in the game against Rockford, we did a pretty good job of keeping the ball and not exposing ourselves too much.
That Marion match we talked about a little off camera, kind of those counterattacks are what kind of got to you guys. But in general, I don't think the score really reflected on how well and how intense and the effort that your team gave against Marion on Sunday.
It was a great battle the entire first half and most of the second half, and obviously those last 5-6 minutes we were really pressing and exposed ourselves in the back to open ourselves up to that final one. But honestly, if Kike's goal drops in another 6 inches, it's a 2-2 match and those counters never come out.
Yeah, you guys had a couple balls that just kind of hit the crossbar. I mean, the offense continued to kind of produce good opportunities, and I think that's a very good stepping stone going forward into the rest of the conference play, that you guys are creating the opportunities, that just an inch here or there, just a little step, that you guys are getting really close.
We're really happy with what's going on up top, and the guys continue to figure out some of the ideas that we're putting forth. Our biggest thing is making sure we stick to the game plan and do it for all 90 minutes. On top of that, though, the movement of the guys defensively was fantastic on the weekend. They did a really great job of communicating, sliding their lines together, and really covering up some of the passing lanes. And honestly, a little mistake here, a little mistake there, and that's kind of what cost us the end.
We got to talk about him. Kike just continues to really be impressive. 2 goals and an assist on the week. What does he mean to that frontline attack?
He just doesn't stop moving. The guy is an engine that just keeps working from end line to end line, touchline to touchline. And on top of that, the guy has one of the most amazing attitudes you're ever going to meet. Every time he comes off, coach, what can I do better? Hey, sorry I missed that one tackle. The guy is just a fantastic guy to have in the group.
Now, you head into a 2-match week, a non-conference match with IIT, and then you're on the road again. Seems like it just continues this trend, but you guys head to Edgewood. Kind of your thoughts on the 2-match week?
I think it's going to be another tough match with IIT. With them coming into the conference next year, it's going to look like a good chance for us to see what another conference opponent is going to look like coming up for the 2018-19 season. And obviously, Edgewood's had a couple up and downs, but man, they can score, and they have a solid team as well. So I think we're going to have 2 tough matches for us again this week.
Well, we look forward to seeing you guys back out on the pitch. Cougars take to the pitch twice this week. You can always find the live links at CUCougars.com.